Good afternoon, this is Andrew Mount for GG at a very breezy and noisy Wolverhampton. We've just had Yaz in the plastic population, the only way is up, and you can probably hear Queen blasting out Don't Stop Me Now in the background. So I've come as far away from the stand as I can get to try and find a bit of quiet time. Now, Storm Bastard, Storm Wanker, Storm Cara, whatever it's called, isn't due to hit until late tonight or tomorrow morning, but it's still getting pretty breezy here, and it's going to be behind the straight looking at the wind, so still want to be against front runners here though at Wolverhampton, because they migrate towards that inside rail into the swamp where the surface is deeper, and usually the winners are prominent or midfield and just coming off the rail two or three wide at least down the middle of the track. Now we kick off with a couple of amateur riders handicaps over the extended mile. A couple of place pot suggestions for the first race, but no strong opinion. Reavers, Rob, Roy and Pike, Corner Cross. Both system qualifiers for me, but both don't win as often as they should, so place pot only if you're getting involved in that race. Now the 5.30 is more interesting, the second division of this amateur riders handicap, because we've got a terrible favourite here in Let Me Stop You There. Now, Let Me Stop You There is incredibly difficult to win with, probably better on straight tracks too, and although he was second at Southall the other day, that flatters him, but he'll probably be second or third again. He's 1/33 on the all-weather. You can take 5-2 about a horse like that with that sort of profile. I know I don't, so I've got to take him on. The one to do it with is Windsor Lot. He only won a class 7 over course and distance the other day, but he needs a big field, he needs a strong pace. Amateur riders tend to go a little bit too quick, a bit like apprentices, and hopefully they'll go like the clappers and set it up for Windsor Lot in the 5.30. Moving on to the 6 o'clock. Excuse me, my fat fingers just turned the pages of my race card. The one I was interested here, and I say was past tense because I'm disappointed in the draw in stall 12, is Chucky Dunedin for the Keith Dalglish Yard. He's won on 3 of his last 4 visits here. Seems equally effective over 6 furlongs or tonight's trip of 7, but stall 12 is going to make life difficult for him. He tends to sort of race promptly on track, but he might have to use up a little bit too much petrol in the early stages to get across and get a good early pitch. So I'm going to switch allegiance to Lucky Lodge. This one's already been well back, 16-10. Another one who, in an earlier race, likes to come late off a strong pace. He's got plenty of form on this track and at Newcastle, loves the 2 metre. So Lucky Lodge to arrive late and spring a minor surprise. Now the 7 o'clock is suggestions here, White Lion, Berkey Queen and Get the Look. And 2 of those, White Lion and Berkey Queen, at a big price. Berkey Queen, it's all about breeding. My Guta fan, fillies from this side do particularly well, black blind. And Get the Look by Brazen Bow, another side that's doing well. So just a few suggestions there for a place, but not a betting race for me, that seller. I've not looked at the 7 o'clock, the mile and a half novice in detail, but the race of the night has to be the 7.30. That's the 5 furlong class 2, 0 to 105 sprint. Now we've got one of my favourite all-weather horses at the moment running here, Acclaim the Nation. He did really well to finish 4th over trip and track last time out, because he made the run around the inside from stall 1 and stayed in the swamp throughout, and was caught close home. Actually did really well to see off the one in Preston from the lead, Daily Express, who finished well back. But 3 of them came past him in the closing stages. He could only finish a relatively close up 4th. However, will he end up on the inside rail again tonight? Will he get pressed for the lead by Watchable, another one who likes to make the running? If that's the case, then he could set it up for the finishers yet again. I'd prefer Acclaim the Nation at somewhere like Chelmsford, where front runners have a better record. So I'm going to reluctantly oppose him with one of the 2 Tom Morley horses. I might actually do both or do a reverse forecast. Royal Birth, currently heading the market at 5-2, likes to come late. And Street Parade. Now, Street Parade has only had 2 goes on the all-weather, both at Chelmsford, where his come-from-behind style doesn't usually prove effective. And his sire, Swiss Spirit, has got a great record here at Wolverhampton over the 5 furlong trip. 7 wins from 34 for a profit of £16.15 to a £1 level. at stake. So Street Parade at 9-2 might just get the better of the same owner's royal berth there. The 8 o'clock, no strong opinion, but Singing Sheriff looks solid enough. Down in class after finishing second to Felix at Lingfield last time out. Course and distance the time before. And finally, the 8:30. Again, just a couple of suggestions. Hufflepuff and Last Enchantment. That's it from me until next week, when I'll be concentrating on the Cheltenham Festival. You may have heard that big meeting in the Cotswolds coming up. See you then.